Red meat is actually good for you. The more I delve into studies, the more I realize a lot of the correlative studies done on red meat were done on people who eat red meat. What does that mean? People who eat a big steak usually have a fully loaded baked potato on the side.
Marc Lobliner earned this title very handily. I didn't know who the hell this guy was till he somehow popped up in my Twitter feed with this amazing post, which prompted me to ask how steroids or roids were healthy, which then led him to start insulting me, which has now led me to do further investigation on this little guy. So it turns out the guy is a bodybuilder. He runs a business or a few businesses or is affiliated with a few businesses. And he has a website called Tiger Fitness and he sells supplements. He also has a couple of YouTube channels and that's pretty much about it. Apparently the guy is roided to the tits, but he covers it up by saying he's on HRT sometimes. But we'll get to that in a bit. What really got my attention was Mark's incredible capability to explain some of the complexities of how the human body works when it follows an eating pattern it's not supposed to be following. A few years ago, when Sean Faker released his dismal blood work for the internet to laugh at, Marc Lobliner decided to give his interpretation of the poor blood markers of Sean Faker, Baker, in particular, his resting glucose and HbA1c levels. And just to clear this up, for those who may not know about this stuff, your glucose levels and your HbA1c levels are usually two of the main indicators to show if someone has diabetes or is pre-diabetic.
So here's the deal. This is a common lab test result found in low-carb athletes. What the body does, it preserves the insulin and glucose levels for high intensity training. Now, you see a lot of vegans who are endurance athletes.
Mark claims Sean does an anaerobic sport, that being rowing, and is following a low carb diet, which is what is causing his high levels of resting glucose. Sean's body has glucose reserves ready for any type of anaerobic activity, which is why his resting glucose levels are so high. So my question is, where's the proof to back this statement up?
So what his body is conditioned to do, and you see this in low carb performance athletes, we've seen that in some of the data I've reviewed, is his body is adapted to having that glucose and insulin available because his body is trained to tap into that resource quick.
So Mark has reviewed data from other low carbers and I guess has noticed some type of pattern among them. That's the proof he has brought forth. Well, luckily enough for the rest of society, we don't have to resort to anecdotal bro science as we have scientific literature to explain why someone has high resting blood glucose levels or a high HbA1c. The reason why someone has high resting blood glucose levels is because of a problem known as insulin resistance. A person's pancreas simply doesn't make enough insulin to support the demands of clogged tissues, organs, and cells. Fat, and in particular, saturated fat, which happens to be the type of fat Sean Baker consumes the most on his stupid quack idiot diet, clogs tissues, organs, and cells, which impedes the signaling of insulin. Insulin is responsible for clearing excess glucose in the blood by being the key that allows the excess glucose in the bloodstream to enter tissues, organs, and cells. Excess consumption of saturated fat mucks up the ability of insulin to do its job, hence the elevated glucose levels possessed by Sean Baker. The actual mechanism causing impaired signaling of insulin in muscle tissue is associated with intramyocellular triglycerides or lipids. That's why Sean Baker's glucose levels and HbA1c levels are elevated and not that brotastic explanation there by Mark given on how anaerobic exercise impaired with a low carb diet magically causes elevated levels of resting glucose and HbA1c levels. And this this denial that nothing there's nothing to worry about and everything is perfectly normal for an athlete to have such piss poor blood markers is just a stupid excuse. And I would ask if there's any scientific evidence to support the claims Mark has made in regards to Sean Faker's piss poor glucose levels and HbA1c levels, but I'm going to assume the answer is no.
Since he is depriving himself of glucose other than what is converted from protein via gluconeogenesis, his body has adapted. So his performance, the body is a fucking wonderful adaptive fucking being. And you can't just look at it as black and white. You gotta look at the big picture. So vegans, before you get all zealous and say he's gonna die, let's just look beyond that.
Sean Faker's body has adapted. If Sean Faker's body was adapted, then why would his blood markers look like shit? I wouldn't say that defines adaption. I swear, the mental gymnastics these gym bros do is nothing short of fascinating. And what's with the wanna-be introspective look into the understanding of the intricacies of the human body if not one shred of science was shown in his whole video? And the calling out of vegans being zealous, this has nothing to do with vegans. This is science. So what the hell is this guy even talking about?
Let me recap. I tried being a vegan. I believe I lasted 2.5 weeks. And then I was like, I felt weird. I didn't feel bad. I just didn't feel like myself. Just being real. Like, I was a bit foggy. I was doing everything they say to do on vegan diets. And I know vegans are like, no, you didn't. I'm like, yeah, I did.
Feeling foggy and not feeling like himself. Ah, well, yeah, that just makes all the sense in the world. Clearly, some animal flesh or animal secretions will clear all that up for him. It isn't the fact that he was doing it wrong or is potentially lying. It was the plant-based diet that jacked him all up. I find it really hard to believe Mark followed a properly planned plant-based diet when he states comments like this.
Red meat is actually good for you.
Let's see what exactly Mark means by how meat is healthy for human consumption.
All the studies I've found have shown that actually cholesterol and all that actually enhances your ability to prolong dementia in older individuals.
Wait, what did he just say?
All the studies I've found have shown that actually cholesterol and all that actually enhances your ability to prolong dementia in older individuals.
So cholesterol prolongs the ability to have dementia. How exactly is that a good thing? Okay, let's just assume what Mark meant to say is that cholesterol helps prevent and not prolong dementia, as I don't know anyone who would want to prolong such a horrific disease. Either way, if Mark is saying dietary cholesterol is protective towards neurological diseases, then how did the 23,000 plus people who were involved in this meta-analysis who had higher total cholesterol levels have higher rates of dementia? I've seen absolutely zero data from any scientific publication showing a positive association between having a high cholesterol diet or having high cholesterol in general and better brain health. Although more research is still needed on the cause of different forms of dementia, the evidence seems to point to cerebral arterial stenosis, which is the clogging of arteries going to the brain, and oxysterols, which are able to get past the blood-brain barrier and have an influence in progressing different forms of dementia, or at least Alzheimer's, which is a type of dementia. So absolute bro science statement by the professor trying to give the world some bro tips that may further progress their chances of acquiring one of the most feared chronic diseases known to man. Bravo, Mark. Thanks for making everyone's nightmare that much closer to becoming a reality with your shit videos on the topic of nutrition. And just to cover my bases here for anyone who still wants to argue dietary cholesterol and saturated fat do not raise serum cholesterol levels when consumed, this is all I have to say. Yes, it does. Get over it. I'm tired of explaining this as I've done so in already way too many videos. Check out the link above so that You can get all the studies and read them for yourself if you so desire. I really don't understand how anyone allows the giant cock of science to continuously keep slapping them across the face when the evidence is so apparent and in such abundance. You know, you don't have to let science keep doing that to you if you would just read it and not let your bias get in the way. So I think that's enough science for one video at the moment. Let's go ahead and drift to the tweet that sparked my curiosity to this introspective little guy. You want to see the brief interaction between myself and Mark? Go ahead and check out my previous video where I break it down more methodically, to say the least. Anyway, I simply asked, when were roids healthy, after Mark posted this legendary post, and he responded with this tweet. Funny enough, just months after that little back and forth between Mark and I, he posted this.
Now, what I want to caution about against is the use of illegal steroids, is the use of black market steroids. Not because I'm against steroids, I'm not. I'm on steroids, guys. I'm the poster boy for HRT use. I love steroids. I love steroids. I love steroids.
I love steroids.
I love steroids.
I love steroids.
Well, there you go. He claims he's on HRT in his tweet, but is now claiming to be on steroids. That happens to be a part of his HRT protocol. So I guess everything's all good now. So what is he on? Testosterone, androgel, and HGH. But he may throw in some other compounds as he gets closer to competition day or whatever the hell this guy does.
Now, as we get into the show, we can add in additional compounds. Prescribable, there is Anavar, and Winstrol are prescribable. It's full transparency for y'all.
Ah, just a little bit of Anavar and Winstrol. Never really hurt anyone. I'll say this again, as I did in my previous video. I don't give a damn what this guy takes. He's just a part of fake fitness. And this type of mentality that perpetuates drug use as acceptable just because people are open about their usage is ridiculous, as that is not real fitness. It's fake fitness. But if you like him, and if that's your thing, kudos to you. I don't give a damn. Let's move on.
Cam awesome. He's a vegan. Fucking great. I mean, guy's a fucking elite athlete. Gary Reinel, being an elite athlete on veganism. I don't believe it's the optimal human diet. I just don't. However, if you factor in the ethical reasons for it, I fucking appreciate and respect vegans. I don't think they need to get all militant on everybody. But again, like, if I felt like you killing this animal was fucking murder, then yeah, I'd be fucking mad too. So if they look at animals like humans, as we all, like, I look, dude, my dog, that's my fourth kid. You know, I understand. But I don't think it's an optimal diet.
It's a great thing that Mark only has a belief, and his beliefs are only rooted in bro science, as you heard from that epic amount of nonsense he just spoke. How exactly are the substances found in animal products healthy? Cholesterol, saturated fat, HCA/PH, PAHs, high amounts of endotoxins, high acidity. How do these substances increase health in humans exactly? But whatever, we don't have to get it, like, too sciencey here. After all, professors only profess bro knowledge, and you know how they feel about science. Just as a quick note, I typically don't talk too much about animal ethics much when I do these types of professor videos, but since Mark wants to bring it up, we'll discuss it. So Mark sees his dog as his fourth child, and he says vegans see animals as humans, which I assume this is why he thinks vegans want the animal agriculture business to come to an end. And I would have to disagree. Vegans don't see other animals as humans, but as other sentient animals or beings we happen to share this planet with, that don't deserve to be born into a world of enslavement, torture, rape, and eventual murder for reasons that are logically and scientifically unsubstantiated. The difference between a vegan and Mark is a vegan is able to come to terms with this truth and is willing to do something about it. This doesn't mean vegans are better than people like Mark, or that vegans deserve to be praised, as that is completely missing the point. The point is to end this needless suffering because it's hellishly cruel to the victims. That's it. Ladies and gents, I hope I didn't tug too hard on your heartstrings, but the time seems right. Mr. Marc Lobliner, here is your award. Just to wrap this ceremony up, I want to say to Mark, please take it easy with the bro science. It's not like if there's any type of shortage out there. It was incredibly painful to have to watch a few of your videos and hear you spew such absurdities as everyone witnessed. Either way, for anyone who has made it this far in the video, please let me know what you think in the comment sections down below. As you know, I love to engage with all of you. Please feel free to rate, subscribe, and hit the ding dong button if you haven't already. Please know that I appreciate every single one of you. I'm the Natural Hulkster. I want to thank you all for watching, and please stay tuned for the next one.